Today's show and the following message are brought to you by Trevitt Hill. Cannabis investors expect big returns from the companies that they invest in. Unfortunately, not all cannabis investments succeed. Trevitt Hill's management team works with investors to help turn around, or in some cases purchase, their underperforming portfolio companies. To learn more, go to trevitthill.com.
Trying to drill down on what are your grams per hour in total context. I mean, what is your cost per gram? What is your cost per hour? What are the KPIs that are interesting to our clients to help them become more competitive in the marketplace and certainly manage their operations more efficiently?
It's the MJ Bulls Podcast, a show about raising cannabis capital. I'm Dan Humiston, and on today's show, how this veteran from the technology industry has created a program to help cannabis grow facilities manage all the complexities of their organization. Today in the Raising Cannabis Capital series, we are joined by Kevin Gorman, who's the CEO of ThingBlu. Kevin, welcome to the MJ Bulls Podcast.
Thanks, Dan. Great to be here.
If you have a license to grow cannabis, your life is pretty complicated. And I mean, just staying in compliance, staying on top of all the things that you need to stay on top of, that's not even to mention all the things that you have to manage just to stay profitable. It's really, really complicated. And I know, Kevin, you did a ton of research before you launched ThingBlu. How much time are owners or were owners and key management wasting because of inadequate management tools?
Well, interesting. A recent survey, a year ago, came out that showed they were spending on an average 25 to 30 hours a week just on data, hunting data, cutting, pasting, reconciling data, data entry errors. And then all of this kind of trickles into the whole company in general, their organization. So you look at compliance and how this impacts compliance by not having the proper records available to just running your company and having the visibility that you need to see what's happening and how much is that costing you.
I mean, the information seems like it's stored in so many different places, and trying to consolidate it all, like you said, is just such a time waster. Well, tell us how ThingBlu helps management be more efficient.
Well, to your point, Dan, what we're still seeing today is what I refer to as old school tools. Lots and lots of spreadsheets, whiteboards, post-it notes, and then a lot of disparate databases. Anything from seed to harvest tracking systems to human resources and financial. What ThingBlu has done is brought a platform of technology services to the industry to help consolidate these disparate databases, as well as provide a workflow engine that helps our clients pull these costs together as the tasks are being completed. So it's kind of a task management system. What has to be completed? When is it being completed? By who? And how much did it cost? And we can take these costs, assimilate them with other costs to start giving our clients a more accurate picture of their margins.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like on your website, I'm just reading through some of the things that you can drill down for these people. You know, grams per hour. Like, I mean, you can really, really get it right down to the key indicators that they need to run their company.
Exactly. And so, like with our processors, similar statistic in terms of what's your cost per order, what are your margins? So how much are you making by this strain, by this order, this retailer? The whole goal here is, you mentioned our website and looking at some of dashboards that we present and reports. We focus in on visibility and understanding, and then easily digestible information presented in these dashboards and reports that enable our clients to make data-driven decisions. It's all geared towards operational efficiencies and cost reductions.
Like we said in the beginning, staying in compliance is one thing, but also trying to be profitable. You need all these key indicators to make sure that your payroll is efficient and you're not wasting money on, you know, a lot of money slipping through the cracks.
And so each client, we can create their own set of KPIs. Now, there will be some overlap, obviously. You mentioned grams per hour, which we were talking about for the last 4 years with clients, trying to drill down on what are your grams per hour in total context. And then what is your cost per gram? What is your cost per hour? What are the KPIs that are interesting to our clients to help them become more competitive in the marketplace and certainly manage their operations more efficiently.
I want to take a minute to remind all of our listeners about a new podcast produced by MJBulls Media. Hemp Barons is a weekly show about the companies, products, and entrepreneurs who are using this amazing plant to create and improve the products we use every day. You can listen to Hemp Barons every Tuesday on Apple iTunes, Stitcher, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts from. So you're up and running, and ThingBlu is being used, but we're moving into, you know, phase two right now, and that's really your next phase right now, and that is penetrating the market. Tell us what your plan is for expanding and growing your company.
So right now it's word of mouth, but our long-term vision for ThingBlu is literally lighting up the entire supply chain, because we start at the source. So in terms of, you know, where do we go from here? We need capital for growth. You know, we need more developers, more salespeople, more marketing. But also recently, we've been approached by a consortium of companies. It consists of multiple retailers, a distributor, a processor, and then multiple growers. And they've asked us to take our capabilities and serve as a foundation across all of their organizations and also an online marketplace, so that at the end of the day, a retailer and their online presence will have a full what's called omni-channel perspective. Omni-channel is if you have an online presence and brick and mortar, that's a 360, and it's an omni-channel approach to the marketplace. But the problem in that scenario, which Target and Walmart and all the others discovered when they moved in that direction, was in order for that to be effective, you've got to have clarity and visibility of inventory. So you look at just about all the retailers today I've talked to are using handheld scanners to do inventory management at the end of the week. And then you have your online presence, which is saying, okay, I believe we have this much left in inventory. And then as well as stock in order, first in, first out, out of stock capabilities, just that whole inventory visibility that as you're looking at depleting certain strains, as an example, of certain products, being able to look backwards and say to your distributor or to your supplier, how are we doing here? Because I'm running low on this. The next step, obviously, would be predictive analytics, which is one of the things that we'd be providing as well in terms of as the inventory levels reach a certain threshold, then those raise alerts as well.
Okay.
And so a company like ThingBlu, we provide that kind of perspective from point of sale back. And then you have the headsets and New Frontier and BDS analytics that take it from the point of sale outwards. So there's potential synergies for working with companies like that as well.
Wow. You have a lot on your plate. You have a lot on your plate.
We do.
Yeah. So tell us a little bit about, you mentioned in that you're raising capital. Tell us a little bit about your raise.
Well, to date, ThingBlu has raised $240,000, which has gone just completely towards development and a little bit of sales and marketing. Our next raise, and this is based upon the proof of concept project that has now landed on our desk. So we're looking at raising $750,000 to $1 million, which are directly allocated towards growth, more sales and marketing, some development, and then this omni-channel project that we have on our desk.
Okay. So $750,000 to $1 million is where the raise is right now, and everything's going to be on the MJ Bulls website. Well, Kevin, this is a pretty ambitious project. I think it's complex, but it seems like I can't believe somebody hasn't done this. It's like it needs to be done.
It is complex. So we take the complexity and we hide it. So like in our processor, as an example, the workers there have a very simple interface to use. They love it, by the way. It's actually, in addition to all the efficiencies and cost reductions they're experiencing, kind of created another value add, because they're looking at, okay, like I'm doing 200 grams an hour. I know I can do 210. So they're starting to set bars for themselves as well.
Well, that's neat. Yeah, they're kind of pushing themselves based on the information that you're providing. They're saying, we can do better than this. That'll be really helpful.
It has been. And like I said, they're loving the system right now.
Well, Kevin, thanks for being on the show today. And let's stay in touch. We'll maybe do a follow-up a little bit down the road after you get the raise finished.
Sounds great, Dan. Thanks so much.
You're welcome. Good luck. Just a quick reminder that you can become an MJ Bulls member for just $4.99 per month and enjoy exclusive access to companies' pitch decks and the MJ Bulls Cannabis Capital Directory. Join today at MJBulls.com. Thanks for listening to the MJ Bulls podcast. To learn more about today's guest or to become a guest, visit our website at MJBulls.com. Today's show was produced by Bumminute Media, with original music composed by Jamie Humiston. I'm Dan Humiston, and you've been listening to the MJ Bulls podcast.